Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? So today I'll be teaching you all English. So we will be continuing the lesson that we have left behind in our previous class. So this lesson, as I said you, it's about children speak up. This lesson name is children speak up. So it's a little speech that was given by a 13 year old girl who was a member of WNC, your ECO, that is Environment Children Organization. So here there were like four children. This organization was made by the four children. The name of the children were Severin Suzuki, Vetsana Sute, Morgan Glister, Michelle Quick. So these were the four children who made this organization, and they have traveled 6,000 miles away from their home to put forward their voice to words to save the environment and how to come up with the ways. So this little girl, her name is Severin Suzuki. She is trying to explain the importance of the environment near us. She's seeing how difficult it is for the future generation to see and to admire the beauty of the nature. Now, she's also explaining how animals doesn't have any place to live, how children are starving under the poverty line, how it's difficult to go out in the sun. Why? Because there are holes in the ozone. And obviously there is some water pollution due to which fishing is also become an issue. Now, not only that, she's also worried about how these plants and animals are going extinct day by day. Now, she's also trying to say that when she was young, she has dreamt about the forest which were green, where wild animals were running, the rainforest which was built with, which had many species of birds and butterflies. But now there is none such thing, and now she is wondering that these kind of things only appears in movies or televisions. Are these fantasies not real? And she is asking to the men, the adults around her, that whether these people have ever thought or ever dreamt about the consequences that they are going to face if forests are going to cut down. Now, I shall be reading the next lesson. Here you may be delegates of your governments, business people, organizers, reporters, or politicians. But really your mothers and fathers, sisters and brothers, aunts and uncles, and all of you are someone's child. I am only a child, yet I know we are all part of family. 5 billion strong. In fact, 30 million species strong. We all share the same air, water, and soil borders. And governments will never change that. I am only a child, yet I know so. All are all in the together and should act as one single word towards one single goal. In my anger, I may not blind, and in my fear, I may not afraid to tell the world how I feel. Now she's saying that though we may be the delegates, though we may be the reporters, or business, or organizers, or politicians from different countries. Though we may be divided by boundaries, though we may be divided by some kind of LOCs, but we need to stand straight, we need to stand together, we need to stand united. Why? Because we all live on the same earth, we all live on the same land, we all share the same water, we all share the same earth. So this is for our mother earth that we have to save it. We should not get blinded if we are in anger. We should not get scared if we are in fear. The only motto in our life should be how to save this forest for our future generation. Though I may be a kid now, though I may be young, but I understand the consequences of later life. I'm only a child yet. I know if all the money spent on the war was spent on ending poverty and finding environmental answers, what a wonderful place this earth would be. At school, even in kindergarten, you teach us how to behave in the world. You teach us not to fight with others, to work things out, to respect others, to clean up our mess, not to hurt other creatures, to share, to not to be greedy. Then why do you go out and do the things you tell us not to do? Now, what she is saying that, I may be only a child, I may be a 13-year-old child, but I have spent, and you may tell me that whatever the money we have spent in the wars is because we wanted to end poverty, we wanted to find environmental answers. But you should understand what a wonderful place Earth is to live in. At school, when we are in our kindergarten, that is your PP1, PP2, or in your nursery, teacher teaches us to not to care to others, not to show disrespect, not to hurt creatures or small animals, to clean up our mess, not to respect others, and not to be greedy. But when you are teaching all this to us, why are you doing this by yourself when you are out in the world and you are all grown? Do not forget, why are you attending these conferences? You are doing this for your own children. You are deciding what kind of world we will grow up in. Parents should be able to comfort their children by saying, everything is going to be alright, it's not the end of the world. We are doing the best we can, but I don't think you can say that as to anymore. Are we even on your list of priorities? My dad always says, you are what you do, not what you say. Well, what you do makes me cry at night. You grown up says you love us. I challenge you. Please make you. Actions reflect your words. Thank you for listening. So now she's saying that, do not forget why are you attending these conferences that are based on environment and how to save environment. So she's asking all the adults that you are attending these conferences to save your children, to save this environment for your children. So do not forget it. Rather than it, you should be grown up and you should be happy for the what kind of world and what kind of earth you were grown up in. Now our parents always say that, our parents always says that everything is going to be all right. But how can it be all right when all the adults are trying to harm it, when all the adults are trying to harm it, and everyone wants the end of this world, when everyone want the end of this world? Now she's saying that my dad always says that. She's saying how her dad explains that what we are not what we say. We are not what we say, but we are that what we do. Okay. So what is this particular sentence means? Hum log what we say. Okay. What we say, we are not that. But our action shows our attitude. Our action shows our personality. Our action shows our character. Though we may bluff around that we are big people, we have such a good character, but your actions represent it all. So her dad is saying it similar way. So she's saying, please listen our cries, please listen the animals' cries, please listen the people's cries who are under the poverty line. Make us proud, and I challenge you, please, whatever you're doing, let your actions reflect it. Thank you for listening. So this was a little speech that was given by this girl who was trying to put forward her voice and her concern towards the environment. She tried to put her concern and care towards the environment, and she was successfully able to give a speech in front of delegates and politicians. She expressed how animals are being suffered, how trees are being chopped away, how rivers are getting polluted, and how this, if the same thing continues, this thing is not, uh, the environment is not going to survive for our future generation. So I hope you people also understood the value of clean environment, and you will do whatever is in your hands to keep your environment clean and green. So Allah Hafiz everyone. Hope you all understood. I will see you in the next class.